Wrexham FC reckons that it benefits from fan ownership. Although income was down, the operating loss was just £36,000 last year, and fans have invested £1 million in the club, not counting their volunteer labour. Solid set of accounts, Ellis Short will be able to recoup some of the money tied up in the £140 million debts he has cleared to facilitate the sale of Sunderland. The agreement with the purchasing consortium does not include the Hilton Gardens Inn Hotel, which is situated opposite the Stadium of Light. Short will also retain an area of land next to the hotel, which has planning permission for a further development, with the two having a combined valuation of £30 million. Charlton fanzine editor Rick Everett has tweeted, "The substantial money behind the Charlton takeover bid is American, I have heard tonight, although it's still Aussie-fronted." Another social media report states, "New Charlton owners are Scott Farquhar and Mike Cannon-Brookes. They are the Sydney-based founders of software giant Atlassian. Nothing to do with Time Waster. Andrew Muir. Both very, very rich." No doubt there will be some more twists and turns in this long-running saga. Everton owner Farhad Moshiri is looking to increase his shareholding in the club to close to 60% by purchasing the shares of the deputy chairman John Woods. Moshiri paid £200 million for a 49.9% share in the club 2 years ago and is now seeking to exercise an option to buy the 8.9% owned by Woods, which would take the share to 58.9%. Moshiri's proposed purchase would leave the chairman Bill Kenwright 12.2% as the only other shareholder with more than 5%.